Welcome to your coverage of Missoula Sports Heroes. You're tuned in to the Missoula Prep Sports Network live stream of local sports.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ladies and gentlemen.
This presentation of Missoula Sports is proudly powered by Fuel Fitness, the only gym from Montana for Montana.
Check it out.
MPSN is your leader in Missoula's prep sports. We now take you to the action on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Everybody hustles out there, okay, guys? Nobody quits.
Hello, folks, and welcome into the final game of the first day of the 2019 AA State Legion Baseball Tournament. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network as we get ready for the Lethbridge Elks and the Billings Royals, the final game of the day. We had three winners and three losers. We'll go through that as the game goes, but let's first meet our lineups. For the Billings Royals, who are the designated away team, as the top-seeded team is dubbed the home team. Jaden Jorrell will lead things off at second base. Connor Hunter is the shortstop. Dan Blanchard will stand on the five valuable pitcher's mound. Braden Concepcion is the third baseman. Nick Eliason is in right field. Chase Hinckley in left. Cole Miller will be the catcher. Brendan Miller is the first baseman. And rounding out the order is the center fielder, Michael Moorhead. It is, as I mentioned, Dan Blanchard on the five valuable pitcher's mound. For the Elks, Calum Haney will be the shortstop to lead off. Levi Abbott at second. Ty Penner's at third. Brendan Schultz at first. Noah Waters is the center fielder. Ty Weavers is the catcher. Skylar Braun, the designated hitter. Zach Trempner in left field. Dalton Demers in right field. And the pitcher, Thomas Little, rounding out the order. So they are announcing the Elks. We've had the opening ceremony. I hope you caught that on the stream. And it was pretty awesome to have that ceremony, the presentation of the flag, the presentation of the Legion and the Armed Forces members in the crowd. Made for a very fun opening ceremony. So now we get ready for the final game of our day. The Billings Royals and the Lethbridge Elks. Our umpires, behind the plate, it's Tim Vigilotti. First base is Craig Burby, who is the UIC umpire in charge, and Bob Allen is at third, a three-man crew. Now they will have the Legion pledge.
Keep faith with my teammate. Keep my temper. Keep myself fit. Keep a stout heart in defeat. Keep my pride under in victory. Keep a sound soul, a clean mind, and a healthy body. Let's play ball.
And as the PA announcer said, let's play ball. And we get set to go. These Lethbridge Elks come in as the number four seeded team. And it would be the Billings Royals at number five. As we go through the game, I'll break down today's events and the teams that advanced and teams that fell to the loser side of the bracket. You have to win two. You can't lose two. Otherwise, you are out. And we get Thomas Little on the five valuable pitcher's mound warming up. Jaden Jordal up to bat first. Connor Hunter is on deck. And Dan Blanchard in the hole. The Royals, managed by Brian Benjamin. Great guy. I talked to him last night at the banquet. Always fun to talk to him. He's always a good spirit and always has good things to say. And some insight, too. I always enjoy talking sports with him. He's a great guy. And then we've got Scott Okawa, the manager for the Lethbridge Elks. Now, Okawa is the second longest tenured manager in Montana Legion Baseball, right behind the Missoula Mavericks, Brent Hathaway. Hathaway at 29 seasons, and I was told Okawa at 25 seasons. And those two gentlemen, I'll tell you what, it's like a couple of teenage boys when they get together. It's a lot of fun to watch their games. We're ready for our first pitch here in Billings at Dealer Park, and the first pitch is tossed in for strike one. First pitch at 7:33. We're only a half hour behind. Little with the stretch and set upstairs. Ball one. Now, as the Mavericks play-by-play announcer, I have seen Thomas Little this year, as he is an ace pitcher. And this one's going to be hit into center field, hard, short, and one away to start the game. So we go to Connor Hunter. One out, nobody on. Ty Penner, Thomas Little, I've seen this year, is the first pitch into Hunter, will be ball one. And well, with the rest of our Legion players within the state, they are right up there as some of the top pitchers. Pitch over the plate. Strike one. One and one on the count. One out. Nobody on. Top of the first. Connor Hunter. And a low pitch brought in for ball one. Good job by Ty Weavers to keep the ball in front of him. Now, taking a look at our day, we would have the Helena Senators and the Kalispell Lakers play the first game as the pitch comes in for ball three. Three and one on the count. Helena Senators as the sixth seed, the Kalispell Lakers as the third. And here's a shot into center field. Backing up is Waters, puts it in the glove, and there's two outs here in the opening frame. Takes us to Dan Blanchard with two outs and nobody on. So the Lakers and the Senators would play the first game. Senators would get the win 3-2 over the Lakers. So the Senators move on to the winner's side of the bracket. The Lakers fall to the loser's side. And a pitch outside brings up ball one to Blanchard. Game two would be the Missoula Mavericks and the Great Falls Chargers. Mavericks claiming the number one seed as this one's fouled off. One and one on the count. And the Mavs would get the win 9-1 over the eight-seeded Great Falls Chargers. And an outside pitch brings up ball two, two and one. So the Mavericks move on, and the Chargers fall to the loser side of the bracket. That brings us to game number three against the number seven-seeded Billings Scarlets with a foul ball to bring us to 2-2. The Billings Scarlets would take on the Bozeman Bucks. The Scarlets are the number seven seed, the Bucks in the number two seed, an 11-4 win for the Bucks to advance them, as we get a pitch in for a full count at 3-2. So the tables are set for three of the four games tomorrow. At 10 o'clock, the Lakers will play the Scarlets as this one swung into center field, and it looks like Waters is going to get some work in the first inning as he will have all three outs. 1-2-3, bottom of the first, right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Warning! Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash are at it again. They've taken what was already the best wash in town, the best value in town, and made it even better. Now, whenever you gas up your rig at Fast Trip Conoco, you can clean it up for half price. Yeah, you heard that right. When you fuel up your car at Fast Trip Conoco, you can get any wash at Magic Touch Car Wash for half price.
Warning! Warning! This is not a drill.
It's the Gas It Up, Clean It Up special at Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash on reserve across from Larchmont.
Half price wash only valid when purchased at the pump or in Fast Trip Conoco. Advertising on the web can be intimidating. Where do you start? What is the most effective way to reach the audience you are targeting? Milk Crate Media can help you reach your audience, whether it is social media marketing or creating a unique commercial for streaming or for radio advertising. Milk Crate Media can help you build a new website or rebuild your existing website that will bring users back again and again. Visit www.mcratemedia.com today. Milk Crate Media is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports in Missoula and the surrounding valley.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We come to the bottom of the first inning. Scoreless. The Lethbridge Elks have their chance to bat. 4 and 5 seed teams going on right now. Final game of the day. It is Dan Blanchard on the 5 valuable pitcher's mound for the Lakers, the Elks. It's Calum Haney to start the inning. Here's the pitch. Fouled off. Strike one on the foul ball. Got something weird in here on my lineup I'm trying to figure out as strike two is brought in by Blanchard. Something hinky going on. Here's a shot into left field and it's in the glove for the first out. One away. There we go. So with the out in left field, brings us Levi Abbott. Blanchard delivers over the plate for strike one. Pitch on the way. Outside. 1-1. So, Dan Blanchard on the 5 Valiador pitcher's mound, a very capable ace for the Royals. He's had a good season this year as we bring in ball 2-1. And this game is going to be determined by pitching. Here's the pitch by Blanchard. Rolled right to Blanchard. And the throw to first, stick on the bag by Miller. And the ground out. We're bringing up the second out. We come to Ty Penner now. Ty Penner, another one of those Vauxhall Academy athletes that is with the Lethbridge Elks, both Little and Penner. Penner steps in. Two outs, nobody on. Blanchard with the delivery, and it's high in the zone for ball one. Two outs, nobody on. Bottom of one. Here's the pitch. Swung on, fouled off, and we're even at one apiece. So before the inning expired for the Royals, I was talking about our schedule. Tomorrow morning, it is the Kalispell Lakers and the Billings Scarlets in a win-or-go-home game. As this one's delivered in for ball 2-1. Outside, ball 3. The 1 o'clock game, well, that's the Chargers, and they will face the loser of this game, as this one's over the second baseman's head, ripped into right field, chased down by Eliason, and Penner will be the first runner on for the Elks. Brings up Brendan Schultz. So we've talked about the 10 o'clock and the 1 o'clock game. The 4 o'clock game will have the Helena Senators and the Bozeman Bucks. That is, well, the Chargers, they wait for the loser of this game. And that's the 1 o'clock game, and that is a win-or-go-home game as well. So both 10 and 1 are win-or-go-home. Upstairs pitch by Blanchard will bring up ball one. So the 4 o'clock game stays or goes to the winner's bracket. That's the Helena Senators and the Bozeman Bucks at 4 p.m. The nightcap, the Missoula Mavericks taking on the winner of this game as ball two is delivered. So those are your four games tomorrow. Monday we'll have a setup with three games. 1, 4, and 7. Tuesday will be two games with 4 and 7. And then Wednesday, as this one's outside for a ball, 3-0. Wednesday's the championship, and if the team that loses in that championship game, it's their first loss of the tournament, well, we'll reload and play one more time. Pitch outside, and it's a walk to put runners at first and second for the Elks. Brings up Noah Waters for the Elks with two outs, two on. Dan Blanchard standing on the five Valley Lord pitcher's mound, awaiting Waters to step in. Here's a roller out to the second baseman, picked up by Jordal. The throw to first, and the inning's over. So low runners stuck on bases, we stay zeros. Back with the top of the second right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Hockey Wolf and Lacrosse Wolf is Missoula's one-stop shop for all your hockey and lacrosse needs.
Check this out.
It may be warm outside, but you can still take care of your hockey fix in their one-third sized indoor rink.
Really? Wow, crazy.
Stop in to 1010 North Avenue West and see what they have in store for your hockey needs. Hockey Wolf and Lacrosse Wolf is a proud sponsor of high school sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Get Montana strong at Fuel Fitness and Nutrition. Montana owned and Montana proud. Your $29 a month Montana Mega Gym. Fuel has premier facilities with the latest equipment, nutrition superstores, high energy classes, refreshing smoothie bars, attentive childcare, expert trainers, and we never close. Best of all, you have access to 6 locations statewide for just $29 a month. That's less than a dollar a day. Get Montana strong at Fuel Fitness and Nutrition. Go to clubfuelfitness.com right now to find a Montana location near you.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We come to the top of the second inning. Goose Eggs on the scoreboard. Lethbridge Elks and the Billings Royals. Royals will have their 4, 5, 6 batters up. Thomas Little stands on the 5 Valley Otter pitcher's mound. Brendan Conception stands at the plate. Conception, Eliason in the on-deck circle, and Hinckley in the hole. First pitch by Little is ball one. Upstairs brings up ball two, 2-0. Now, you'll be able to catch the A-State tournament on the Missoula Prep Sports Network. As Concepcion will swing for strike one, 2-1. Go to the MPSN homepage. Go to the live link in the top left corner. And it'll give you the option for the AA or the A tournament as we bring up ball three, 3-1 to Concepcion. You can watch both games, or both tournaments, as a pitch over the plate takes us to a full count at 3-2. Little with the delivery. And it's a walk to start the inning. Nikolaisen now for the Royals with one on and no outs. Top of two. Bunt, and this one's high and over the backstop into the eighth row. Foul ball will bring up strike one. So Eliason will settle back in. And it comes in for ball one, 1-1 on the count. Brian Benjamin, the Royals manager, down the third base line, sends the signal in, and Concepcion will step away. Little goes to first. Concepcion's hopping on the bag, and he's set. Here's a foul ball up over our heads. Strike two, 1-2 on the count. Eliason settles. And the 1-2. And that one will come off of Eliason's helmet. The hit by pitch will put runners at first and second with no outs. Brings up Chase Hinckley. And our umpire, Tim Vigliotti, will ask Hinckley to step out. Here's the pitch. Ball one. Showing bunt is Hinckley, looking to put the ball behind the play, advancing runners. Strike one, 1-1 on the count. First day of the AA state tournament. It is hard to believe that the boys of summer are finishing out their season. Pitcher over the plate brings up strike two, 1-2. That means that we're about 30 days away from school starting for all of the other kids. That means fall sports, football, volleyball, cross country, golf, all getting underway. Outside pitch brings up ball two, 2-2 on the count. And a swing will strike out the batter for the first out of the inning. Runners holding at first and second. So all the teams doing, or a few of the teams doing team bonding for the tournament. The Billings Scarlets last night at the banquet, as Cole Miller will swing for strike one. 0-1. So it'd be Hawaiian shirts for the Billings Scarlets last night at the banquet, including coaches. Pretty cool to see Coach Hoost in his bright yellow and orange Hawaiian shirt. The Missoula Mavericks would have their team blonding. Now I'm saying team blonding because, well, the Mavericks all dyed their hair blonde. Swung on for strike two, 0-2. And then for the Billings Royals, it would be a stash bond, as the Royals, the ones that can, grew out mustaches for this tournament. A swing will strike out the batter. Back-to-back strikeouts. Puts two outs on the board, and Thomas Little, after putting runners on at first and second, pulls the dirty pitch out of his pocket. striking out the next two. Takes us to Brendan Miller, and Miller with a check swing. Doesn't matter. The ball's over the plate, and we've got strike one. Little outside, 1-1 on the count. Bottom of the order in the on-deck circle for the Royals, and Miller will call time. Here's the pitch. And that'll bring up a foul ball to take us to 1-2 on the count. Two outs. Eliason at first, Conception at second. Here's the 1-2. And we get 2-2. Little with the stretch and set, the lefty. High pitch behind the plate, and that'll advance runners. He'll throw to third, and that one goes over the third baseman's head, and they'll go ahead and bring Conception home on the air. And with a throw in on the air, that will advance a runner to third. And the Royals get on the board. 1-0. So, Miller will be walked. And runners on the corners with two outs. One nothing on the... And they're actually going to bring back Miller. And Benjamin will have a discussion with our plate umpire. Clarification on the count. It was ball four. And that's runners on the corners, and now that'll bring out the pitching coach to check in with Thomas Little. And Little will have a moment with his pitcher and catcher. The pitching coach will have a moment with Little and the catcher, Weavers, and it's a brief conversation. Brings up Michael Moorhead now. Bottom of the order for the Royals. Two outs, runners on the corners, one run scored as Little will deliver inside for ball one. Here's a roller to the second baseman, picked up, the throw to first, and the inning is over. The Royals strike blood with a run to make it 1-0. Elks get to bat next, right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Do you have a property you'd like to sell? Maybe you're looking for a new place to call your own. Well, you're in luck because the Kelly Touch is the local realtor for you. Whether small or large, the Kelly Touch would love to help you find your piece of Montana to call home. From Kalispell to Florence, the Kelly Touch has the experience to help you buy or sell property throughout western Montana. The Kelly Touch, your professional real estate needs met. The Kelly Touch is a proud sponsor of high school sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Stitches of Missoula is your resource for embroidery and screen printing. Give Stitch a call today at 406-529-2632 to speak with their super friendly staff and have them take care of your embroidery needs. From business logos to team jerseys, Stitch's Embroidery can help you and your team look good. Check them out online at stitchesmontana.com to see their full line of silkscreen and embroidery options. Stitches is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Welcome back to MPSN. We've got the bottom of the second inning here in the final game of day one of the 2019 AA State Legion Tournament. The Billings Royals getting on the board first, 1-0. For Lethbridge, it's the 6-7-8 batters due up. Ty Weavers to lead off. Skylar Braun on deck and Zach Trempner in the hole. Dan Blanchard stands on the 5 valuable pitcher's mound. He'll deliver the first pitch of the inning. And it's swung on for strike one. Our plate umpire, Tim Vigilotti. Craig Burby is on first base, and our third base umpire is Bob Allen. Pitch comes in for a ball, 1-1 on the count. Blanchard now with the stretch and set. Ball two. This one's bounced out, chased down by Jordal. He'll pick it up, the toss to first, and the leadoff batter on the inning is out off of the ground ball. One away. Brings us to the DH. Skylar Braun. One out. Nobody on. Lethbridge Elks and the Billings Royals. The Royals are the host team. Low pitch. Brings up ball one to Braun. Brings up ball two on that pitch, 2-0. Here's the pitch. Foul ball. Takes us to strike one, 2-1 on the count. To Braun. And one of the Maverick moms, Dylan Chalmers' mom, chasing down the foul ball. 2-2 on the count. Here's the pitch. Outside, full count, 3-2. One out, nobody on. Payoff pitch to the third baseman. Throw to first is on target and in ahead of the runner. As Burby will punch out the runner at second.
The left fielder, number 7, Zach Krempner.
Takes us to the number 8 batter, Zach Krempner. Two outs, nobody on. Here's Blanchard. Over the plate for a strike. 0-1 to Trempner. Swung on, brings up strike two, 0-2. So Trempner going for the fence. Ball one, 1-2. Here's a roller to the third baseman, picked up by Conception. The throw to first is off, and Miller will actually toss his glove. The error will advance the runner to second, and that one's overthrown as well. So with two outs, the Elks will have a runner at first. Brings up Dalton Demers. Blanchard spies the runner at second, steps off the rubber, forces Trempner to head back. Here's the pitch, and it's swung on. That one got a curve off the bat into center field, tracked down in the glove of Moorhead, and the inning is over. That ball had a banana curve. We go to the top of the third. Royals holding on 1-0. We'll be back right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Have you recently found yourself in a situation where you need a lawyer? Give our friends at Tip Coburn & Associates a call today. They have been practicing injury, employment, and criminal defense in addition to other areas of law for the past 55 years. Give Tip Coburn & Associates a call today at 406-549-5186 or stop by their website at www.tipcoburnandassociates.com. Tip Coburn & Associates, lawyers fighting for Montana since 1959 and proud sponsors of Missoula Prep Sports on MPSN. The Missoula Prep Sports Network is Missoula's home for high school sports, and we need your help. MPSN is looking for local businesses to help us cover our local high school athletes by advertising their business on the Missoula Prep Sports Network. If you know of a business that would be interested in helping the Missoula Prep Sports Network in our coverage of high school sports in the Missoula area, drop us a line by using the Contact Us link at MPSN406.com. MPSN, Missoula's home for Missoula's prep sports heroes.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. Top of the third inning. Royals lead 1-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. For the Royals, it's the top of the order. Jaden Jordle. Thomas Little stands on the 5 Valley Little pitcher's mound. He'll toss in the first pitch. It'll come off of Little's glove. Picked up barehanded by the shortstop, and it's an error. And Jordle will be on. So that takes us to Connor Hunter with one on and no outs. Hunter showing bunt. Brings up ball one. For Connor Hunter, his first at-bat was a line drive. Here's Little with the stretch and set. Bunt laid down, and this one is going to be called fair. And Weavers cannot control the ball, and the runner will get on. Runners at first and second now with no outs. And they will clock that as an error on Weaver. Takes us to Dan Blanchard, the pitcher. And Little will deliver ball one to Blanchard. 1-0. Here's the pitch, swung on. Strike one, 1-1 on the count. Here's the pitch, foul ball into the netting. Brings up strike two, 1-2. Blanchard, a line drive, 0-1 on his at-bats. Runners at first and second, no outs. And a pitch over the plate will strike out the batter looking for the first out of the inning. Brendan Concepcion now to the plate with one out, runners at first and second. Royals leading 1-0. here in the second. We're in the bottom of the second. Outside pitch will bring up ball one. Conception was walked his first at bat. Pitch on the way. And they're going to say strike two. He did commit on the check swing. 1-1. Little now, 49 pitches in, as this one will bring up strike two. So we'll say 50 pitches for Little, 27 over the plate. Here's Little with the stretch and set. Foul ball keeps us at 1-2. So the Kalispell Lakers and the Billings Scarlets will play at 10 in the morning. That is a win or go home game. The first two games tomorrow will be win or go home. As this one's fouled back to keep Conception going at 1-2. 1 o'clock game is the Chargers. They await the loser of this game. That is a win or go home game. As we go back upstairs for a ball pitch, making it 2-2 on the count. Here's the stretch and set. Check swing, and they look down the line. It'll be ball three, full count. 3-2. Here's Little with the payoff pitch, and it's strike three for the second out. Conception thought he had the base. And Vigilotti gives us the phone book tear for the second out. Takes us to Nick Eliason. Runners at first and second and two outs. Top of the third. Foul ball for Eliason, brings up strike one. And the runner at first is stuck in the jam. They'll come home and a run will score while they're playing catch between first and second. Jordal sneaks his way around off of the stolen base. One and one on the count. And it's 2-0 Royals. 2-1 on the count. Here's a foul ball to make us 2-2. Nick Eliason hit by a pitch, his first at bat. He'd actually take it off of the helmet. And a play pitch over the plate will end the inning on a strikeout. We go to the bottom of the third. Royals leading 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Back right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
If you're looking to upgrade your car, stop by Five Valley Auto Sales. From the moment you walk through the door, you'll be in for the best car buying experience ever. From their large inventory to their experienced staff, Five Valley Auto Sales is committed to helping you find the right car for you. View their featured vehicles online at www.fivevalleyautosales.com or stop by their location at 3300 South Reserve Street in Missoula. Five Valley Auto Sales is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on MPSN.
When your workout window is small, you don't want to travel far, wait for parking, and hope for an open machine. Let Fuel Fitness and Nutrition ignite your life with no waiting. Fuel has plentiful parking and 30,000 square feet of weight and cardio training equipment. When you want it, you'll get it at Fuel. Businesses don't hesitate to sign up with Fuel. We have enough parking and equipment to handle your entire staff and 24/7 access so they can get in shape around work schedules. Ignite your life with no waiting at Fuel Fitness and Nutrition in the Holiday Village Shopping Center.
Welcome back to MPSN as we go to the bottom of the third inning. The Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. It's the top of the order for Lethbridge. Calum Haney to lead things off. Levi Abbott on deck and Ty Penner in the hole. Dan Blanchard will deliver the first pitch of the inning, and he's over the plate for strike one. Pitch delivered for ball one, 1-1 on the count. Thomas Little and Dan Blanchard battling it out on the pitcher's mound. Here's a roller out to Hunter at short. Throw to first. Miller sticks the bag, and that'll be an out on the ground ball to the shortstop. One away. Takes us to Levi Abbott. Abbott settles in, and Blanchard delivers ball one. For Abbott, it was a ground out his first at-bat. And we still have a good crowd here in the stadium after the opening ceremony. Teams and players and parents sticking around. This one is whacked foul, and we get 1-1 on the count. Bouncer, shortstop, picks it up. The throw to first. Miller sticks the bag, holds on. No, the ball gets loose. And the runner will be on. And we'll see if the Royals will pick up. They do. That will be an error on Miller at first. So one out. One on. Miller thought he got him on the pickoff. So Ty Penner at the plate. Pitch over the plate to Penner. Brings up strike one. Penner with a single, his first at-bat. Swing brings up strike two, 0-2 to Penner. Penner, patient at the plate, brings up ball one. 1-2 on the count. One out, runner at first, and Penner lets it go by for ball two. 2-2. Penner, an intelligent baseball player, an intelligent athlete. Throw to first, Penner swings. Foul. Keeps himself going at 2-2. Brendan Schultz in the on-deck circle with one out and one on. Inside pitch takes us to a full count, 3-2. Blanchard now sets on the rubber. And the payoff pitch. Nope, they're going to throw to first. Here's the 3-2. And Penner puts this one in right field, chased down by Eliason. Runners at first and second with one out now. Penner with back-to-back singles. One out, and we get Brendan Schultz. And our umpire, Vigilotti, with a friendly comment to Cole Miller, the catcher. You know, conversations go on all game long between catcher and umpire, batter and umpire, but you never see the umpire's portion of it. He's got his back to the crowd. Here's the pitch. Swung on. This one's popped into center field. Moorhead chases it down to the gap, and it's in the glove. Runners will stay at first and second off the pop fly. Two away. Brings up Noah Waters. For the Elks. Two outs, two on. Blanchard now taking his time, sets. And a swing by Waters will bring up strike one. For Noah Waters, it was a ground out, his first at-bat. Two zero Royals on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Here's the pitch. And that one gets away from Miller. Runners will advance to second and third as Miller chases it down. And we'll be 1-1 on the count. Lights are on here at Dealer Park. Set below the rim, as they call it here in Billings. Beautiful park here. Over the plate, strike two, looking. Here's the 1-2 by Blanchard. And we'll go to 2-2. Waters in the box, and Blanchard will step off the rubber, now back on. Runners at second and third, two outs. Here's the 2-2. Swung on, and the inning's over on the swinging strikeout. Top of the fourth, right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Some changes in life are too painful to go through alone, and Cunningham Law can help in making difficult decisions from divorce to child custody. Kyle Cunningham focuses solely on family law. Cunningham Law will help you land on your feet when big changes come to your family and life. Visit www.familylawmontana.com or give Kyle a call at 406-203-4678 today. Cunningham Law Services. You don't have to go through this alone. Cunningham Law is a proud sponsor of the Northwest Regional Tournament.
The Chris Stratton Show is Missoula's resource for local high school sports. Get fresh takes like...
But this year shows a lot of difference. We're all working together. We're having fun. We're competing. No injuries. And I think we're just there.
Get the rest of the show by downloading the podcast on iTunes or at www.thechrisstrattonshow.com.
Welcome back to MPSN, Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We go to the top of the fourth inning, the Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. It's Thomas Little, and Little will roll this one, or Hinckley will roll it off the pitch. On the ground ball, Hinckley's out. Thomas Little standing on the five Valley to pitcher's mound. That's what I meant to say.
The catcher, number seven, Cole Miller.
Pitch over the plate brings up strike one to Cole Miller. Miller, the catcher. Ball one, 1-1 on the count. Here's a swing for strike two. 1-2. One out, nobody on, top of the fourth. Little outside, ball two, 2-2. Thomas Little, the ace for this Lethbridge Elks team. He also plays with the Vauxhall Academy. As it comes inside to bring up a full count at 3-2. Here's the pitch. And it's strike three as the cord is ripped by Tim Vigilotti. And there's two away. We go to Brendan Miller now. Here's the 2-0. And Brendan Miller will let it go for strike one. For Brendan Miller, it was a walk his first at bat. And we'll bring up strike two. Even though it was tight inside, Vigilotti says that is strike two, 0-2. Two outs, nobody on. And this one will dribble down the first baseline. It is picked up by Schultz, and he'll win the race to the bag. 1-2-3 for the Royals. Bottom of the fourth, right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Advertising on the web can be intimidating. Where do you start? What is the most effective way to reach the audience you are targeting? Milk Crate Media can help you reach your audience, whether it is social media marketing or creating a unique commercial for streaming or for radio advertising. Milk Crate Media can help you build a new website or rebuild your existing website that will bring users back again and again. Visit www.mcratemedia.com today. Milk Crate Media is a proud sponsor of
Did your computer go down? Don't worry, Mike's Print and Copy has computer rentals available until you can get your computer replaced. In addition to computer rentals, Mike's has self-serve copiers so you can take care of your printing needs at your time. Do you have large-scale printing that needs to be done? From high-tech blueprints to large quantities, Mike's Print and Copy is your print store. Stop in and say hi to Mike at their new location at 1605 South Avenue West in Missoula. Mike's Print and Copy, proud sponsors of the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. The Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Dan Blanchard back for his fourth inning of duty on the five Valley Idol pitcher's mound. 2019 Montana-Alberta AA Legion State Tournament. The 4 and 5 seeds finishing out the first day of play. The winners today, Helena Senators, the Bozeman Bucks, and the Missoula Mavericks. And we're waiting for our fourth winner right in this game. It is 2-0. Leading off the catcher, Ty Weavers for the Elks. So it'll be the 6-7-8 batters, Weavers, Braun, and Trepner. Pitcher over the plate, brings up strike one. Outside pitch. Ball one, 1-1 on the count. For Weavers, it was a ground out, his first at-bat. Over the plate, brings up strike two, 1-2. Here's the pitch. Swung on, and the first batter is struck out swinging by Blanchard here in the bottom of the fourth. Takes us to the designated hitter, Skylar Braun. Here's Blanchard with the pitch, and he's got it over the plate for strike one. Minutes into the game here in the bottom of the fourth with one out. This pitch gets away from Cole Miller, and we'll be 1-1 on the count. And they've got the lights on here at Dealer Park. We're preparing for the sunset as it's touching the horizon to the west of us. This one's shot into center field, Moorhead with the leisure catch, and there's two away. Takes us to Zach Trempner for the Elks, the left fielder with two outs and nobody on. Here's Blanchard with the pitch. Foul ball into the netting, brings up strike one, and some of our fans below us flinching on that one. We have Maverick fans sitting down below us here. I don't want to say too much. Although back at Lindbergh Craig Field, this one's going to be rolled out. The attack by the shortstop, Miller with the grab, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 for the Elks. Top of the fifth, right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Hey, are you going to try out that new gym? I hear it's really cheap.
Not a chance. They don't have group exercise classes with awesome instructors like we get at Fuel. And the owners are in New York City. What?
New York City!
Mm-hmm. The New York way is not the Montana way, so no way.
Fuel Fitness and Nutrition, your Montana born and bred fitness chain. And unlike the others, we never close.
Warning! Warning!
Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash are at it again. They've taken what was already the best wash in town, the best value in town, and made it even better. Now, whenever you gas up your rig at Fast Trip Conoco, you can clean it up for half price. Yeah, you heard that right. When you fuel up your car at Fast Trip Conoco, you can get any wash at Magic Touch Car Wash for half price.
Warning, warning, this is not a drill.
It's the Gas It Up, Clean It Up special at Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash on reserve across from Larchmont.
Half price wash only valid when purchased at the pump or in Fast Trip Conoco.
Welcome back to MPSN. We have the top of the fifth inning. The Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Game four of the 2019 Montana-Alberta AA State Legion Baseball Tournament. Thomas Little stands on the five valuable pitcher's mound for his fifth inning of duty, and he'll bring it into Moorhead. Moorhead with the bunt down the first base line, and Moorhead will not be able to beat out the throw. And there's one away.
Second base, number 24, Aiden Jordle.
We go to Jaden Jordle, top of the order. One out, nobody on. Thomas Little brings up ball two with that pitch. 2-0 on the count to Jordal. Foul ball brings up strike one. 1-1 on the count. The Mavericks awaiting the winner of this game. This one's lifted into right field, and it's in the glove of Demers. That's two away. Takes us to the shortstop, Connor Hunters. Two outs, nobody on, and Little will deliver ball one. So the Royals, they've got two runs, but no hits. Two errors and three left behind for the Royals. For the Elks, no runs off of two hits as ball three is delivered. 3-0. Check swing, and that'll bring up strike one for Hunter, Connor Hunter. A line drive and reached off an error his last at-bat. For Thomas Little, it's 78 pitches. And he'll put it over the plate for strike two, 2-2, and I'm off on my count somewhere here. I've got 3-2. The scoreboard says 2-2. And that will bring up ball three. So I got ahead of myself somewhere. It is now a full count, 3-2. And it's a walk. The Royals will have a runner at first. With two outs. Brings up Dan Blanchard, the pitcher. Upstairs for ball one. Thomas Little at 81 pitches now, which means that we will not see him on the Five Valley pitcher's mound for the rest of the tournament. After 80 pitches, it requires, or 81 pitches. Here's the throw down the line to first. We'll have ball two. But at 81 pitches, it is required for 4 days rest. Back to first. Good friend Paul Yarbrough watching back in hashtag Our Town is Superior, enjoying the Legion State Tournament. Ball three, 3-0. I am on track on the count this time. For Blanchard, a line drive and a strikeout looking. Well, he'll have a walk this time. And with two outs, the Royals have runners at first and second. And that'll bring out the pitching coach to check in with Little. Little at 84 pitches. The infield will come in. And the pitching coach checking in with Little. We were at the banquet last night, and the Elks were sitting at the table next to the one I was at. Thomas Little stood up, and, well, it was like the Jolly Green Giant standing up. He was right next to me standing up at the table and sitting down. I'm a short guy. But Thomas Little, they don't have the Lethbridge height and weight. But he's got to be all of 6'6", if not 6'7". Here's a swing for strike one by Conception. Two outs. Runners at first and second. Time is called. Conception, a walk and a strikeout looking. As our plate umpire, Tim Vigilotti, settles back in. Here's the pitch by Little. And this one will roll out. Third baseman will have it. The throw to second will be ahead of the runner, and that is the inning on the fielder's choice. It stays 2-0 Royals. Lethbridge with the bat next on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
If you're looking to upgrade your car, stop by Five Valley Auto Sales. From the moment you walk through the door, you'll be in for the best car buying experience ever. From their large inventory to their experienced staff, Five Valley Auto Sales is committed to helping you find the right car for you. View their featured vehicles online at www.fivevalleyautosales.com or stop by their location at 3300 South Reserve Street in Missoula. Five Valley Auto Sales is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on MPSN. You have a property you'd like to sell? Maybe you're looking for a new place to call your own. Well, you're in luck because the Kelly Touch is the local realtor for you. Whether small or large, the Kelly Touch would love to help you find your piece of Montana to call home. From Kalispell to Florence, the Kelly Touch has the experience to help you buy or sell property throughout western Montana. The Kelly Touch, your professional real estate needs met. The Kelly Touch is a proud sponsor of high school sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We have the bottom of the fifth inning, the Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-0 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Dalton Demers will lead things off, bottom of the order for the Elks. Dan Blanchard stands on the Five Valley Auto pitcher's mounds. He's at 59 total pitches on the game here in the bottom of the fifth. So Demers steps in, bottom of the order for the Elks. Game four of the 2019 as the bunt is laid down. It's going to be a clean bunt, picked up by the third baseman. Throw to first, and Miller does a good job of blocking in front of him. The runner will get on. That was a reach regardless of the throw. And we'll go to the top of the order. Calum Haney now at the plate with one on, no outs. And the throw to first. The Elks might be down on the scoreboard, but they are a team that is extremely capable of being able to come up with runs as this one's punched high into left field. Hinkley is there, and there is the first out of the inning. Brings up Levi Abbott for the Elks with one on and one out. Blanchard with the stretch and set. And Abbott puts this one into the gap. Chased down, picked up by Eliason. Runners at first and second now. One out, two on. Bottom of five. Brings up Ty Penner, and Benjamin's going to come out, the manager for the Royals, and check in with Blanchard. Blanchard at 62 total pitches. 39 over the plate before he faces Ty Penner. And the Penner at bat could be lethal for these Royals with runners at first and second. Demers and Abbott have wheels, so a ball put into play could see one, if not two, runs scored. And Benjamin setting up his infield. And they're wanting coaches to go into the dugout down the first base line here. The Elks having the first base dugout. Expecting bunt, they'll throw to second, and a step on the bag is not in time. Expecting Penner to bunt. infielders racing in. Blanchard now set on the rubber. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Strike one for Penner. For Ty Penner, it's back-to-back singles for his two at-bats. The pitch. Outside. Ball one. 1-1 on the count. One out. Runners at first and second. Blanchard with the pitch, and the lefty will foul it into the dugout down the first baseline for strike two. And Penner is one that I've seen at least, not with this group, but with the Vauxhall Jets. They are a baseball academy out of Canada. As Blanchard will step off the rubber, forcing runners back. 1-2 on the count to Ty Penner, one out. Levi Abbott at first, Dalton Demers at second. Here's the stretch and set by Blanchard. And Penner peels this one foul over the third base dugout. But we stay at 1-2. Here's the stretch and set by Blanchard. Swung on, and this one's ripped back into right field. That's right where Penner puts him. And it's loaded bases with two outs off the Penner single. Brings up Brendan Schultz now. One out, runners standing on all three bags as the first baseman comes to the plate for the Elks. Here's Blanchard, and it looks like Yarbrough is headed to the bullpen. Upstairs, ball one. Let me double check my numbers here. Tucker Smith, I apologize. Over the plate for strike one, 1-1. I know I got the voice of summer excited with the mention of Yarbrough going to the pen, but Yarbrough is actually warming up the pitcher for the Royals. Ball pitch makes it 2-1. So Benjamin going to his bullpen. Schultz swatting at the bugs. And Vigilotti with a comment to him that brought a smile to both umpire and batter. Here's Blanchard now with the 2-1. A roller up the gut. Good block. Down to second, down the line to first, and the runner will reach with a score behind it, and the Elks are on the board with two outs. 2-1 off the fielder's choice. Brings up Noah Waters now with two outs. The Elks on the board. Sorry, Paul. And the first pitch to Waters will be ball one by Blanchard. Two outs, bottom of five in a seven-inning game. Foul ball to the top of the netting. Brings up strike one, 1-1 on the count for Waters. A ground out and a strikeout swinging. his first at-bats. Throw back to first. One and one. Swung on for strike two. Royals looking to get out to leave the runner at third and Levi Abbott and get out of the inning with just one run scored against him. Ty Weaver's in the on-deck circle. Here's the 1-2 by Blanchard. Swung on, and it is a strikeout to end the inning. One run scored to make it a one-run game. 2-1 Royals. Top of six right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Did your computer go down? Don't worry. Mike's Print and Copy has computer rentals available until you can get your computer replaced. In addition to computer rentals, Mike's has self-serve copiers so you can take care of your printing needs at your time. Do you have large-scale printing that needs to be done? From high-tech blueprints to large quantities, Mike's Print and Copy is your print store. Stop in and say hi to Mike at their new location at 1605 South Avenue West in Missoula. Mike's Print and Copy, proud sponsors of the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Have you recently found yourself in a situation where you need a lawyer? Give our friends at Tip Coburn & Associates a call today. They have been practicing injury, employment, and criminal defense in addition to other areas of law for the past 55 years. Give Tip Coburn & Associates a call today at 406-549-5186 or stop by their website at www.tipcoburnandassociates.com. Tip Coburn & Associates, lawyers fighting for Montana since 1959 and proud sponsors of Missoula Prep Sports on MPSN.
Welcome back to MPSN as we come to the top of the sixth inning. The Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-1 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Missoula Mavericks waiting for the winner. The winner will play at 7 p.m. tomorrow night against the Mavericks. Thomas Little continues his time on the five Valley Auto pitcher's mound. And the lead off the inning for the Royals will be Nick Eliason, the right fielder. So 5-6-7 in the order due up. Here's Little with the first pitch of the inning. Ball one. So Thomas Little at 87 pitches, 47 of them over the plate. This one finds the plate for strike one, 1-1 on the count. For Nick Eliason, he was hit by a pitch his first at bat and then struck out swinging. Back outside for ball two, 2-1. Here's the pitch. Upstairs, 3-1. Now we've seen action in the bullpen for the Royals. Okawa for the Elks, sticking with his ace. And it's a walk to start the inning. We go to Chase Inkley now, the left fielder. One on and no outs. Elks getting on the board, and Okawa comes out to the warning track, and he will send a signal in. He comes out to the fringe on the warning track on the inside here. Expecting bunt, bunt showing, and we will have strike one to Hinkley. Hinkley with a strikeout swinging and a ground out. His two at-bats. Here's the stretch and set by Little. He'll actually go to first. Hinkley settling back in, 0-1. No outs and a runner at first in Eliason. Here's the pitch. Ball one. 1-1 on the count. Pitch on the way. Fouled back into Hinkley. And that one's tough because that one came off of the ankle. Those are rough. Hitting that little knob on your ankle. No protection there, just a little flab of skin. And we go 1-1 on the count. I thought it was 1-2, but I might be off on my pitch count, so we'll wait. As Hinkley settles back in, Eliason is at first, takes his leap. Here's the pitch. And we're outside for ball two. We'll see if... And that's exactly what our plate umpire, Tim Viglotti, gives us, is the 2-2. And Hinkley will call time. Ball three, 3-2. Full count to the left fielder with no outs. Here's the pitch. And it's a walk. Runners at first and second for the Royals. Okawa paces at the gate to the dugout down the first baseline. Cole Miller now, the catcher, and Okawa is going to make the walk out to check in with Abbott, or Little. Thomas Little, 97 pitches, 50 of them over the plate. And there's no warm-up, so if there is a pitching change, it'll come internally. And Okawa shakes his head, nods, and begins to converse with his infield. So Sunday, 10 o'clock, Kalispell and the Billings Scarlets. Win or go home. 1 o'clock will be the Great Falls Chargers and the loser of this game. Win or go home. The 4 o'clock game is the Helena Senators and the Bozeman Bucks. Winner stays on the winner's side of the bracket. And the nightcap, Mavs. And the winner of this game, the winner, stays on this side of the winner's side of the bracket. So Okawa comes back, and he'll discuss something with our plate umpire, Vigilotti. Cole Miller now set at the plate. Little shakes off the first and nods at the second. Now the stretch and set. Bunt showing brings up ball one. For Cole Miller, pair of strikeouts. The first one swinging, the second one looking. No outs here in the top of the sixth. 1 hour and 21 minutes into this game. Bunt laid down to the pitcher. They'll throw to third, and it's a hop off the bag. And they say the out will happen on the fielder's choice at third. That's the first out of the inning to cut off the lead runner. Takes us to Brendan Miller now with one out. Runners at first and second. One of the Lethbridge coaches trying to signal the outfield. We'll have 1-0 on the count. Back outside for ball two. 2-0. For Brendan Miller, walked his first at bat and then a ground out. As Little steps off the rubber, I meant. Oh, I see. There is a ball they got loose down the first base line. There's some young people in a grassy area and general seating down the first base line in the outfield. They're playing with a baseball, and it made its way onto the field. So safety first. Time is called. Inside pitch across the first baseman for ball three, 3-0. And that was almost one of those pitches, folks, where the pitcher is saying, step off my plate. And time is called just as Little is ready to release. And Ty Weavers with some sort of signal to the dugout. Nathan Ryder steps deeper into the dugout and shakes his head. So I don't know if that was meant for him, but we're going to have a walk to load the bases with one out for the Royals. That'll be pitch 103, and Okawa puts the clipboard down and heads to the umpire. I don't think he's going to call for a pitch count. Now Okawa will head out there, and looks like Ty Miller is going to make his way to the pitcher's mound. Little will hand the ball over to Okawa, and we'll have a change. So we'll be back in just a moment as changes are made on the field. Royals with loaded bases and one out. Back after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Have you recently found yourself in a situation where you need a lawyer? Give our friends at Tip Coburn & Associates a call today. They have been practicing injury, employment, and criminal defense in addition to other areas of law for the past 60 years. Give Tip Coburn & Associates a call today at 406-549-5186 or stop by their website at www.tipcoburnandassociates.com. Tip Coburn & Associates, lawyers fighting for Montana since 1959 and proud sponsors of Missoula Prep Sports on MPSN.
Get Montana strong at Fuel Fitness and Nutrition. Montana-owned and Montana-proud. Your $29 a month Montana Mega Gym. Fuel has premier facilities with the latest equipment, nutrition superstores, high-energy classes, refreshing smoothie bars, attentive childcare, expert trainers, and we never close. Best of all, you have access to 6 locations statewide for just $29 a month. That's less than a dollar a day. Get Montana strong at Fuel Fitness and Nutrition. Go to clubfuelfitness.com right now to find a Montana location near you.
Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash are at it again. They've taken what was already the best wash in town, the best value in town, and made it even better. Now, whenever you gas up your rig at Fast Trip Conoco, you can clean it up for half price. Yeah, you heard that right. When you fuel up your car at Fast Trip Conoco, you can get any wash at Magic Touch Car Wash for half price.
Warning, warning, this is not a drill.
It's the Gas It Up, Clean It Up special at Fast Trip Conoco and Magic Touch Car Wash on reserve across from Larchmont.
Half price wash only valid when purchased at the pump or in Fast Trip Conoco.
If you're looking to upgrade your car, stop by Five Valley Auto Sales. From the moment you walk through the door, you'll be in for the best car buying experience ever. From their large inventory to their experienced staff, Five Valley Auto Sales is committed to helping you find the right car for you. View their featured vehicles online at www.fivevalleyautosales.com or stop by their location at 3300 South Reserve Street in Missoula. Five Valley Auto Sales is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on MPSN.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We have the changes as Ty Penner moves from third to the pitcher's mound. Ty Weavers is now at third and not behind the plate, and the designated hitter, Skyler Braun, is behind the plate at the catcher position, and Michael Moorhead will be the first batter that Penner will face. So for Thomas Little, as the pitch is delivered over the plate for strike one. For Ty Penner, it would be 5 1/3 innings, 103 pitches, 51 over the plate, 2 runs. Neither one of them earned. No hits, walk 7, struck out 6, and hit 1 as the ball pitch will come in to make it even at 1 apiece. So we get Ty Penner now. With Michael Moorhead, loaded bases, and one out. Top of the sixth. Here's the pitch by Penner. And a foul ball brings up strike two. 1-2 on the count. 1-run game. Royals lead 2-1 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Penner with the stretch and set. The Royals with a pitcher up, and a reaching swing by Moorhead will be a strikeout for the second out of the inning. Two away. Brings up Jaden Jordal now. And it's now number 2 in the pen throwing, Nikolaisen. for the Royals. Top of the order, Jaden Jordal with two outs and loaded bases for the Royals. Here's the pitch. Inside for ball one. The stretch and set. And a hit. This one's over the second baseman's head into the glove of Waters, and the inning is over. Loaded bases stranded. And holding on, 2-1 are the Elks. Bottom of six right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
The Chris Stratton Show is Missoula's resource for local high school sports. Get fresh takes like...
But this year shows a lot of difference. We're all working together. We're having fun. We're competing. No injuries. And I think we're just there.
Get the rest of the show by downloading the podcast on iTunes or at www.thechrisstrattonshow.com.
Hockey Wolf and Lacrosse Wolf is Missoula's one-stop shop for all your hockey and lacrosse needs.
Check this out.
It may be warm outside, but you can still take care of your hockey fix in their one-third sized indoor rink.
Really? Wow, crazy.
Stop in to 1010 North Avenue West and see what they have in store for your hockey needs. Hockey Wolf and Lacrosse Wolf is a proud sponsor of high school sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Welcome back to MPSN, Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. Bottom of the sixth inning in a one-run game. It is the Royals leading the Elks 2-1 in the game four of the 2019 AA Legion State Tournament. It's Ty Weavers to lead off for the Elks. 6-7-8 batters, Weavers, Braun, and Trepner due up. Dan Blanchard stands on the five evaluated pitcher's mound. He has 75 pitches under his belt, 48 of them over the plate. The first pitch of the inning will be over the plate to make that 49 strike pitches. And an arm in the bullpen for the Elks as a pitch over the plate will bring up strike two. And Blanchard will deliver a strikeout as Weavers watches the ball go by, and that's one away. Brings up the catcher, number 18, Skyler Braun. Blanchard with the pitch, and that one's off of the helmet of Braun. One on, one out. Takes us to Zach Trempner. And we'll take a look down the line at the third base bullpen to see who is throwing. Throw to first for the pickoff attempt. And that is number 12. Blanchard with the stretch and set. And a swing by Trempner will bring up strike one. Throw back to first. Number 12, Riley Shellack. Bunt showing, and that's going to be fair. Throw to first, and the sack bunt will be out number two. It does advance the batter, though. And we've got two outs. Brings up the bottom of the order for the Elks, Dalton Demers, with two outs and the tying run at second. Here's Blanchard with the pitch, and it comes inside on the lefty for ball one. Blanchard with the nod, and now the stretch and set. Foul ball. Takes us even on the count at one apiece. Three games on Monday, 1-4-7. Tuesday will be two games, 4-7, and our championship game is at 4 o'clock on Wednesday with a possible one after that, depending on how the outcome is. Here's Blanchard with the 1-1, and he's going to step off the rubber, forcing the runner back. Bottom of six, two outs, runner at second in Braunt. Here's the 1-2. This one is into right field. Eliason picks it up in the air, and the inning is over. Braun is stranded. Top of seven right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
The Missoula Prep Sports Network is Missoula's home for high school sports, and we need your help. MPSN is looking for local businesses to help us cover our local high school athletes by advertising their business on the Missoula Prep Sports Network. If you know of a business that would be interested in helping the Missoula Prep Sports Network in our coverage of high school sports in the Missoula area, drop us a line by using the Contact Us link at MPSN406.com. MPSN, Missoula's home for Missoula's prep sports heroes.
Hey, are you gonna try that new gym? I hear it's really cheap.
No way. They don't care what we eat. They serve pizza and bagels, and the owners are in New York City.
What? New York City? That really tans my hide.
Fuel Fitness and Nutrition, your Montana born and bred fitness chain. And unlike the others, we never close.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network. We come to the top of the seventh inning. The Billings Royals leading the Lethbridge Elks 2-1 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Winner moves on to face the Missoula Mavericks. The loser falls to the loser side of the bracket to take on the Great Falls Chargers in a win or go home situation. Ty Penner comes back to the five valuable pitchers mound to try to close out these Royals and give the Elks a chance in a walk-off. Connor Hunter will lead things off. 2-3-4 in the order for the Royals. Hunter, Blanchard, and Concepcion. As Penner warms up here, Penner with six pitches in his relief of Little in that fifth, in the sixth inning, I apologize. So Connor Hunter comes to the plate. Penner steps on the rubber. The righty delivers the first pitch of the inning. Low for ball one. Now we've had action in both bullpens. Swung on, fouled off towards the concession stands. Will be 1-1 on the count. Still have Mavericks in the building. There's some Lakers sitting down below us. Senators have left. They've got the early game, so I'm sure Coach wants them in bed as we get ball two, 2-1. No, the Lakers have the early game. Here's a ball down the third base or first baseline foul, and we'll have strike two, 2-2. And I was talking to Coach Benjamin last night, And we were talking about the subject of managers in professional baseball and the whole Moneyball era that began in the early 2000s. And the debate right now in Major League Baseball is with executives putting together teams and managers not part of the equation. As the first pitch in to Hunter will be ball, or as the pitch will be brought in for ball three, 3-2 on the count. Whether, here's the payoff pitch, foul ball, keeps us full at 3-2. But whether the manager is a viable position in professional baseball, and you know, Moneyball has really changed the way that professional baseball is played, even at the minor league levels, as we get a walk to start the inning by Ty Penner. Takes us to Dan Blanchard now. One on, no outs, top of seven. But at this level, at the Legion level, and I've seen it all summer long, the manager is what put things into place for these teams to be successful. Ball one. And my perspective on it is that Moneyball, or the theory of Moneyball, it has worked, but the manager is still a viable position regardless. Yes, you have executives in the front office that are putting together these teams with players, the general manager, but the team manager, as this one's rocketed foul down the third base line, and that could have been lethal as that one kissed the line and just came out before the first base bag. Foul ball will have us at 1-2. Great play by Schultz at first to try to dive on that one. Benjamin agreed with me. And when I told him that I see the positive effects, the winning effects of the manager in Legion Baseball, his eyes got huge. Here's one that is lifted out into left field, put in the glove by Trempner. And the line drive will be the first out of the inning. He got excited when I said that. Eyes lit up, and he could hardly even get his sentence out of his mouth. He was so excited to put in his comment, and he agreed with me, and he thought the same thing, that the manager, regardless of the level, is an extremely important position within baseball. Neither one of us agreeing with Moneyball, though it has shown success for players or teams to put players in position. Outside pitch, ball one to Brendan Concepcion. That's what I love about this level of baseball. Over the plate. 1-1. Even at the minor league level, with the Missoula Osprey playing in the Pioneer League, which is rookie ball, it's only first and second year players. Pitch over the plate, brings up strike two, 1-2 on the count. But at the professional level, you know, I can see where Moneyball is important, but or where Moneyball has its place in certain conferences, as this one's punched high over second base. Abbott is there, and we've got two away with a runner holding. So with two outs, we bring up Nick Eliason, the right fielder. Top of seven. Here's a roller right up the gut. It'll hop on the fringe, grabbing a gear. Now he slams on the brakes, and Connor Hunter, will be at second. Runners at first and second with two outs. Brings up Chase Hinkley now. number six batter in the order. Top of seven, two outs. Royals leading 2-1. And it looks like they will put the pitcher in the pen back to work. Here's a swing by Hinckley for strike one. For Hinckley, strikeout swinging, a ground out, and then it was walked his last at bat. Here's the 0-1 by Penner. And it slid over the plate for strike two. Here's the pitch now by Penner, 0-2. And that'll bring up ball one. But my ranting, my raving, my soapbox about Moneyball and the manager in baseball, if you will, is over. Here's a rocket into the gap, and this will come down in front of the center fielder. Runner will come around from second. They'll hold up Eliason at third, and the Royals will add a run to their cause to make it 3-1 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. A stand-up double for Hinckley. And the Royals break the no-hitter. Taking us to Cole Miller. Runners at second and third now. Pitch over the plate will bring up strike one. Pitch on the way. Swung on. Brings up strike two for Cole Miller. 0-2. Cole Miller. Back-to-back strikeouts and then a fielder's choice on his last at-bat. Here's the 0-2 by Penner. And laying off will bring up ball one, 2-1. And looking for a pitch count for Penner. I have him at 29. Unofficially. 1-2 on the count as Cole Miller steps back in. Penner with the pitch. Outside. Ball two. 2-2. And I imagine wanting to save Penner at 30 pitches for later in the tournament, we're going to have our pitching change. That will bring out the new pitcher. We'll step aside. We'll get you caught up right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Do you have a property you'd like to sell? Maybe you're looking for a new place to call your own. Well, you're in luck because the Kelly Touch is the local realtor for you. Whether small or large, the Kelly Touch would love to help you find your piece of Montana to call home. From Kalispell to Florence, the Kelly Touch has the experience to help you buy or sell property throughout western Montana. The Kelly Touch, your professional real estate needs met. The Kelly Touch is a proud sponsor of high school sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network. If you're looking to upgrade your car, stop by Five Valley Auto Sales. From the moment you walk through the door, you'll be in for the best car buying experience ever. From their large inventory to their experienced staff, Five Valley Auto Sales is committed to helping you find the right car for you. View their featured vehicles online at www.fivevalleyautosales.com or stop by their location at 3300 South Reserve Street in Missoula. Five Valley Auto Sales is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on MPSN.
Have you recently found yourself in a situation where you need a lawyer? Give our friends at Tip Coburn & Associates a call today. They have been practicing injury, employment, and criminal defense in addition to other areas of law for the past 60 years. Give Tip Coburn & Associates a call today at 406-549-5186 or stop by their website at www.tipcoburnandassociates.com. Tip Coburn & Associates, lawyers fighting for Montana since 1959 and proud sponsors of Missoula Prep Sports on MPSN.
Welcome back to MPSN. Chris Stratton for the Missoula Prep Sports Network as Riley Shellack comes to the Five Valley pitcher's mound. 2-2 on the count to Cole Miller. Two outs. Runners at second and third. And we'll have ball three to Miller. Full count. Shellack with the pitch. And it's swung on and the inning is over. Strikeout finishes the inning. We go to the bottom of the seventh, where the Elks have some work to do. We'll be back right after this on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
Stitches of Missoula is your resource for embroidery and screen printing. Give Stitches a call today at 406-529-2632 to speak with their super friendly staff and have them take care of your embroidery needs. From business logos to team jerseys, Stitches Embroidery can help you and your team look good. Check them out online at stitchesmontana.com to see their full line of silkscreen and embroidery options. Stitches is a proud sponsor of Prep Sports on the Missoula Prep Sports Network.
The Chris Stratton Show is Missoula's resource for local high school sports. Get fresh takes like...
But this year shows a lot of difference. We're all working together. We're having fun. We're competing. No injuries, and I think we're just dead.
Get the rest of the show by downloading the podcast on iTunes or at www.thechrisstrattonshow.com.
Welcome back to MPSN as we go to the bottom of the seventh. The Billings Royals leading 3-1 on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. Dan Blanchard will come in for his seventh inning of duty on the Five Valley pitcher's mound. Caleb Haney, top of the order to start things off. Levi Abbott in the on-deck circle for the Elks. 3-1 Royals on the Fast Trip Conoco scoreboard. The winner will face the Missoula Mavericks tomorrow night at 7. And a ball pitch sent in for Dan Blanchard. 85 pitches, 55 over the plate. Make that 56 to make it 1-1 on the count. This one's punched shallow into center field. Moorhead puts it in the glove, and there's one away on the pop fly. We go to the second baseman, Levi Abbott. Three, one Royals, one out, bottom of seven. Here's the pitch by Blanchard. Off the plate for ball one. Continuing to work an arm in the bullpen. Here's one that's into the glove on the line drive. A good move by the second baseman, Jaden Jordal, on the line drive. We'll bring up the second out as Ty Penner comes to the plate with two outs. Penner settles in. He is 3-for-3, all of them being singles. Outside pitch by Blanchard brings up ball one. Two outs, bottom of seven. Two-run game. And in the past, this is a situation where Penner has stepped up and put one over the fence. 1-1 on the count. I've seen him do it. And he is fully capable of it. He broke the Mavericks' hearts Memorial Day weekend with a home run. This one's a foul ball down the first baseline, and we're 1-2 on the count. Dan Blanchard saying, I've got this, and they're wanting somebody to run out as that ball rolled into play in right field. Chased down by Nathan Ryder. And Cole Miller will take the moment to check in with his pitcher. Brendan Schultz in the on-deck circle. Two outs. Nobody on. Ty Penner slides back in to the box. Here's the 1-2 by Blanchard. Swung on. Into right field, and it'll fall in the gap, and it's another single for Ty Penner. So with two outs, runner at first, we come to the first baseman, Brendan Schultz. And Benjamin taking a moment with our umpire, Tim Vigilotti. Both of them with their books out here. Well, Vigilotti with his book and Benjamin with his lineup card. And they're both discussing something very tightly. Now, Benjamin will actually point out something to our umpire in his own book. Vigilotti explaining something to Benjamin. Benjamin very adamant about something here. Ty Penner was pulled out. I didn't see him come back in defensively. So if he goes from the pitcher's mound out. So let's see what we've got from our umpire here. So it sounds like Benjamin going to a scorecard, and 17, Ty Penner was pulled out of the game from the pitcher's mound, which should not allow him back in to bat. So Okawa coming over to explain his situation. And it's resolved. So Schultz will come to the plate with two outs. We're approaching 2 hours in the game here as Schultz steps up. Two outs, runner at first, bottom of seven. Royals leading 3-1. Here's the stretch and set by Blanchard. And he'll deliver outside for ball one on the lefty. Whipped back to first. Blanchard, 94 pitches. This one finds the plate, even count at one apiece. A hush over the crowd. Now we get set. Here's the pitch. And this one gets away from Cole Miller, allowing Penner to advance to second off the wild pitch. 2-1. Tying run at the plate. Winner moves on to face the Mavericks tomorrow night at 7. Here's the stretch and set by Blanchard. Outside pitch makes it ball three. Three and one. Noah Waters in the on-deck circle. Foul ball gives us a full count at 3-2. And the crowd getting up here on the Royals side of the field. They've got the third base dugout. Blanchard delivers, and it's a walk to put runners at first and second. The tying run at second now, or at first. And they're going to bring a runner in for Schultz. That's Josh Kabayama. Three, So Kabayama comes in to run for Schultz. And we get Kale Mosier to hit. And the first pitch is over the plate for strike one to Mosier. Runners at first and second. Tying run at first. Here's the pitch by Blanchard. Showing bunt, and it'll be delivered. Ball one. Our plate umpire, Vigilotti, says it was up in the zone. 1-1 on the count. Blanchard with the stretch and set. Here's the pitch. Just off the plate for ball two, and the Royals fans not happy with the call. Ty Weavers in the on-deck circle for the Elks. Here's the pitch. Bunt showing, fouled off, and will be even at the count, two apiece. We might have one of the Vauxhall players in the stands here. We do have one of the Vauxhall players. I'm not quite sure which one, but he's wearing a Vauxhall hat, sitting right down with the Maverick parents. Swung on, and it's foul. They're going to say foul. And we get an argument from Lethbridge. Our first base coach argues the play. Our first base umpire, as Okawa is out at first, discussing it. And wanting a clear call, and it was called foul immediately. The two umpires will discuss it. Discussion continues between Okawa, Vigilotti, and Burby. Now, the thing about Burby is he is the UIC umpire in charge. Okawa shakes his head and walks away. Foul ball. 2-2 on the count. Runners go back to their bags. The Royals take a deep breath. Two and two to Kale Mosier. Mosier. And Vigilotti is going to call time. Now he'll allow the batter to step in. Blanchard now set on the rubber. Here is the stretch. Runners at first and second, two outs, and we go outside for a full count at 3-2. Blanchard at 104 pitches. Looking to finish the game right here. Runners go, a roller. Blanchard picks it up, the toss to first, and the Royals advance. The Royals get the win. They will face the Mavericks at 7 o'clock tomorrow night with the win over the Elks. 3-1, a tight, tight game, and the Royals squeak it out at the end. It would be three runs off of two hits, two errors, and 10 runners left behind. The Elks would have one run off a six hit, three errors, and 10 left behind. So games start back up at 10 o'clock tommorrow morning. It is the Kalispell Lakers and the Billings Scarlets at 10. We will talk to you in the morning, folks. Enjoy your evening. Good night.
Thank you for tuning in to this presentation of Missoula Sports.
What a rush!
MPSN's coverage of Missoula Sports is proudly powered by Fuel Fitness.
Always, always, always.
Tune in next time when the Missoula Prep Sports Network has coverage of your local sports heroes.